Good morning. So currently it's around about 7:30 in the morning. The sun hasn't risen yet, as you can see, and I'm out here in Lanzarote getting my 15th half marathon done. So today's one's going to be a nice chilled one. We're going to rush it. We're going to see the sights when the sun comes up anyway. And hopefully we're going to go up a volcano as well. That's what I have planned anyway. So let's put the camera away and I'll get it back out when we got a bit of daylight. Anyway, see you then. It's taking a bit too long for that sun to come up. So we're in Playa Blanca in Lanzarote, and here with the family. This is a family holiday. It's not work, it's not a marathon one. I'm actually here with the family, so yeah, it's lovely over here. Weather's lovely. We've got this nice hotel, slides for the kids, so they're in their element. And I thought I'll get up, get this done. See, I told you, there's not going to be any times broken today. I just want to explore the coastline, hit a volcano, and get back in one piece. So, we're 5k in now. Like I said, no times to shout about. We're at 32 minutes. Too many stops for photos and what have you. But I thought I'd just have a little mention about the marathon, and it's a bit of a touchy subject obviously, but I'm determined to redeem myself and go for that PB, or even a sub 4 would be good. So obviously entered the London Marathon, obviously didn't get a place. Toying with the idea of a charity place, but I don't know, it seems like a lot of responsibility, doesn't it? Or I look at the Manchester Marathon or the Brighton Marathon. So I'll have a think about it, but I would like to train for something. And you know, like I said, get some redemption on the last one. So yeah, that's the marathon plan. So there will be one coming up in spring. Just don't know which one yet. Okay, so I don't know if you can see over there, but that's Fuerteventura. Because we're right down obviously the south of Lanzarote, we can just get a little ferry over. So I think we might do that in a few days. It'd be quite nice. Go and get another fridge magnet, you know? So yeah, look forward to going to see the sand dunes over there. It looks a bit daunting actually, that volcano. There it is. Looks higher than I thought. We'll give it a go anyway. We'll see if I make it up there in the next few minutes. Anyway, let's get these trails done. Right, so before I tackle the hills, I just thought I'd give you my sort of goal for the next, well, for the rest of the year really. Still gonna go do these half marathons as really easy runs, you know, easy going, not easy, but so I won't be getting any high heart rate out of them. But I really, really want to break that sub 20 minute 5K. So I'm gonna put a training plan together. I might do a little video. Where am I going? Yeah, I might do a little video that I'll bring out probably in December. How I got on, did I do it? But it was one of my goals at the beginning of the year. So, and it's probably the only one that I haven't hit. So, I'd love to be able to do it. So, I'm gonna put a little training plan together. I won't tell you about it now. I'll wait till the video, if I do one. And yeah, so that's my plan. For sort of the next 6-7 weeks, obviously, it'd be good to shed a few pounds as well. I've put on a little bit of weight since my ultra. So I'm tipping the scales probably about, well, after this holiday it might be a bit more, but I think it's about 14 stone 8. So put on about half a stone since the ultra. Marathon training just makes you so damn hungry, doesn't it? So that could be the reason why. But yeah, so it'd be great to lose at least a stone before Christmas and see if I can get that elusive sub 20 minute 5K. Okay, so we're at kilometre 12 now, and we are heading back. However, I'm fully aware that these last 8 or 9 kilometres are probably going to take a lot longer than the first 12. Well, let's see how it goes. Okay, so just about to tackle that beast in a couple of minutes, but while I've got you, before I do, it's 15 kilometers in now to this half marathon, and actually this is my 15th half marathon as well. So 15 half marathons while I'm 40 so far. I've got one more month and then I'm halfway through, so really by the end of November I should really be do about 5 more, get up to 20, and then I'm 6 months in, 20 half marathons in, 20 to go. So that's where we're at with my silly little challenge. But anyway, keeps me motivated, so there you have it. So anyway, I'm gonna have a gel now before I tackle that. Whew. Okay, let's go. Get some sort of hill training in anyway while I'm here. Yeah, don't worry, the running has stopped. We're getting there though. So this volcano is 180 meters high. It's called Montana Roja. That's how the British pronounce it anyway. But I think the real way it's pronounced is Roja. So it's Montana Roja. And yeah, we're gonna beat it today. We're gonna do it. I mean, 180 meters isn't too high, but off to 16k. Feeling it in my legs a little bit today, but don't worry, we'll get up there. Me and my not so clean white trainers. Actually, they're not doing too bad.
Wow.
Just wow. Quite hard work going down actually. Feeling it now. Right, let's try and cut across. Don't really wanna. Right, on my way back now. Got a couple of K to go. Just running back. To be honest, there's not much else to see. We've done the coastline, we've done the volcano. We'll do a half marathon. Actually, I'll give you the stats up here for my half marathon. There you go. Absolutely stunning run. It was nice not to have to worry about times or anything like that. Just go out there and enjoy it. And yeah, I feel all right. Legs feel good, considering I've just climbed a volcano. And yeah, I'm ready for the 5K challenge to come now. And of course, obviously these half marathons. I'm not gonna forget about these, don't worry. So until then, have a good one. Happy Halloween. See you soon. Bye.